What is up, everybody? Before we get into the intro for the video, I wanted to talk to you about our brand new merch design called I Am the Meteor. This is directly inspired by our journey as Utah players to take down as many Apex as possible. The beautiful art was done by Shoji Noodles, and you can find it on your very own t-shirt, hoodie, mug, or plenty of other awesome items in the shop, which the link will be down in the description. This directly supports this YouTube and my Twitch stream and helps me further my journey as a content creator. I hope you guys enjoy this beautiful design, and I cannot wait to see how many of you are out there rocking it right alongside me. I hope you enjoy the video. What is up, YouTube? I hope you're having a great today, yesterday, and tomorrow. We're coming at you with another banger aisle video. We're back on our Utah, and we find ourselves a solo Giga roaming around in the woods. They start the fight off very cocky, and you guys are gonna have to watch to see how the fight continues to play out as it goes on. One thing I will say is it is one of the most interesting endings to any fight you're gonna see out of all the ones we've ever posted. I cannot wait to see your comments below. Let me know what you think of how this fight finally finishes at the very end. Also, leave me a like, please. It does help show the video to more people and helps get it out to the rest of the Isle community. Last but not least, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. We are this close to hitting our first goal on the channel, which is 500 subscribers, and I would really appreciate your help to get there. Don't forget to turn the notifications on. It will let you know every single time we post a new video on the channel. I cannot thank you guys enough. Chin kisses to everybody. I'll catch you in the next one. What is up, everybody? Running around as a Utah again. Oh. I thought we heard a little Giga. It seems that we did indeed hear a Giga. We're gonna go check this out. What's up, little guy? Up here somewhere, we're heading toward like canyon-ish. There he is. Gigonian. Get back here. All right, so Gigas, turn well. Obviously can one tap us. Great walking speed. They get their stand back pretty fast. Their left turn is pretty deadly. I really need full stam here as well. I don't want to start a fight with a Giga that can walk me down without full stam. It can burn through my stam pretty quickly, so... Where did you go? Oh, Sneaky Boy! Yeah, right. Alright, I'm gonna sit here and get a little bit of this juice. Let him think that he's safe for a second. He's not. Can't let him get too far, though. Come on, Stam. Alright, I can't wait any longer. I gotta catch up. Still see him over there to the right. He sees me moving toward him, I think? Yeah, he definitely does. I think I want to go left here and try to cut him off. Where are you going? Oh, he is very sneaky, huh? This is trying to be. He's trying to be cheeky out of these trees. I could have killed you there. No. No, I don't think he could have. I don't think he could have. Alright, we want to land 40 to 50 bites. That's the key. And we want to keep him moving while we've done so. If we can do that, we can win the fight. Right hip, good turns, bait him into right turning. Continuously keep him moving while he's bleeding. We should be fine. I really don't like that I'm starting this fight here, if I have to, without full stam. But if he keeps walking away, we're not going to have too much of a choice. He's definitely on high alert. I'm just going to walk. Try to get my stand back as much as I possibly can. The problem is the more I walk and the more he walks, the farther away he gets, the more stam I have to use to catch back up to him. Because he's done that sneaky tree play a couple times, I want to make sure I'm just always in his sights now, so I don't lose him in some trees and then he ambushes me out and gets an easy kill on me. I think I'm just going to start the fight here in this opening. This is a pretty good spot. I know I don't have full stam, but he... I don't think he thinks we're going to attack him. And he doesn't. All right, a free three. Not bad. That's a good start. Okay, he faces us, which means this Giga might want to stay facing. Oh, he's going to give us a back again. We're going to go back in. And three more. We're at six. Yeah, use that sprint. He does get stamina back quickly, though, so we've got to be careful. And see how fast Giga's turn? We've got to be extra careful not to run directly into his mouth if he baits a turn. And another three. We're already at nine. It's a great start. He keeps giving us his back because he wants to walk away, but he doesn't have a choice. He's got to fight now. Oh, good left turn. If he does this, he's going to use our stam. Missed. There we go. I think that's 11 for us. Little mock bite for the homies. All right, he's definitely not fast enough to catch us, but he is fast enough to, like, do weird things at angles, so we've got to be careful about him facing us and cutting us off on our entries. We need him moving, so I'm going to keep rotating around him to keep him moving here. I also want to pull him away from that little peak that he's at, so that we can get behind him a little easier. There we go. We'll get into ambush and try to get around him. He's giving us his left side, and we're going to take it. Good, 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 good. Okay, he goes back to left. Ooh, good fakes. We hit that bite. Missed that bite. I don't like it. I definitely don't like that. Oh, I really don't like that. I want this bite, though. Nice. I think that's 13 for us. And remember, we have to peel after three bites in the river den. So that's why I'm not just riding here. We have to peel. So I only have three chances to hit bites. And then I have to disengage, make a 180 degree turn from his head, and then re-engage. Good turn. We don't have to rush it. We've already landed 13 bites, I believe. There's no need to be overly aggressive. Good job facing us. I think he wants to sprint here. Oh, we got behind him. Good. He's trying to bait us into break checking us, but he can't because he's got a slide. 16. Good start for us. We need a lot more, but that sprinting is really great. It's not great if he pins us up against this. It looks like we can run up this hill just fine. The one downside about the Thenyaw map is its hills are a little harder to traverse than the V3, which is a little bit more polished. Notice how much time I take back here. I'm very patient. At least I try to be. I missed that last bite. I think it's only 18 now for us. And this is smart. This is smart for him to get himself in a place where it's harder for us to enter. Running uphill at him, easier for him to make an adjustment toward our position. And he's trying to get us caught in some of these weird map dynamics. Now he's doing a much better job facing us, which means we're just going to keep turning him to get him off this hill where we have a lot more clearing and we don't worry about getting stuck. 18 bites is no joke. We're not quite 50% of the way there, but we're putting in good work. We're about a third of the way there, maybe a little bit more. Keeping him turning like this is very important, though. One, he's moving. And two, he's getting off that hill, which is annoying for us. He gives us the back again. Oh, that was actually kind of close. He loves ambush, which for a Giga is not great for us. But remember at the beginning of this fight when he said he could have killed us. We'll see if he feels about that. Hold on, gotta focus on running. Oh, he's still running. Oh, he's trying to bite into the trees, catch us slipping. So he was real confident at the beginning of this fight. Let's see if he's still as confident halfway through it. Oh, I missed. 23. So now we are coming up to the 50% mark of bites where we need him. I really don't want him going to that ravine. And notice how patient I was back there. I'm going back in. Wow, that was unexpected for him to be able to just give us to us like that. I don't like it. Let's see if he's smart and uses some of these trees. I think we're at 27 right now. But he started this fight pretty confident. He's making good decisions at some times and then not great decisions at other times. Gotta give him some of those mock bites of what he's trying to give me. Give him a little bit of a taste of his own medicine. I don't like it. Ah, that was a nice little bait into sprint. Is he stuck? Ooh, I don't like that. I'm kind of getting greedy here, but if I can get him stuck on a tree, I can probably get 3 bites for free. I run the risk of getting stuck on a tree as well, though. He's doing a much better job walking me down and facing me now, which is an infinitely more dangerous thing for the Utah than this, which he's doing again. I actually really, really love that he goes into ambush. It's much easier for me to get around him, which I'm going to do again. We get around. I missed my last bite, but we're at 29. I gotta be careful of this. Yeah, he's trying to bait us over that ridge. I don't like this. Okay, cool. He's just gonna start running. Anytime he sprints around like that, it's really good for us. It means he bleeds a lot more. 29 bites. More than halfway through. My gosh, I put myself in a bad spot there. I missed my last bite again. I shouldn't have wasted it. I kind of rushed right there for no reason. More sprinting? You love to see it. Good turn on his part. I don't like it. All right, if he takes this too far into the trees, it's going to get much trickier. But it looks like he just wants to run around, which is completely fine with us. 31 bites. He's bleeding a lot. I don't like it. 33 is fine. We'll go for two. And I don't rush bites. Hold on. Let me get away from him for a second here. I'm going to bait him into continuously moving. Other thing I need to be concerned with is my stamina is now at 50%. Probably a little bit lower. See if we can't get a little stand back while he walks. We're not quite as many bites as we need. The 31's a hell of a good start here. Where I don't like that turn. That was a great bait for him to bait us around that tree. I like this opening, though, if I can take advantage of it. Good sprint for us. Sneak behind the tail. Three with a very lazy exit. Oh my gosh, I'm getting kind of lazy here. Six and a much better exit there. Kind of noticed I was being lazy, so really focused on my exit. I think that's 35, maybe 36. I'd really feel comfortable with, you know, 10 more bites. So 37 or 38 right there. We're getting to the point where he's almost at max bleed. It's been a long fight, so we do need 5 to 10 more bites, but I feel good. Our stam is really the issue at this point. Smart for him to use these trees. I want to kind of bait a sprint out of him. I'm going to go for this if I can. No, he turns left. Smart for him to turn left around those trees. He's using the right side of that tree as protection as well. Or I guess the trees on his right side for protection is a better way to put it. No. Oh. He's still coming. Okay, good. He backs off. Trees are dangerous. Stamina issue, but I can get it back. What if we get a little drinky drink here? I know this is a little bit of bad manners, but sometimes you gotta bait the giga out. So we're gonna take a little drink. Let him think about his mistakes. And let him bleed for a little bit in those trees. He's definitely in a... No way. Well, we did a good job riding the right side, getting plenty of bites. We had the fight won. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Sorry it ended that way, but we did get him to quit, and I take that as a moral victory. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to like the video. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you think about gigas that do that. See you guys in the next one.